If you're looking to create an amazing slider for your WordPress website, you've come to the right place. I'm going to show you how to set up this slider over here in the next few minutes, and I'm going to show you the absolute easiest way to make a slider. On a side note, check out our tutorial on how to create this amazing website right here in a couple of hours, step by step. But anyway, let's start creating this slider right now. Okay, so to create a slider, back in our WordPress dashboard, what we need to do is hover over plugins and go to add new first. Then you'll need to search for a plugin called Smart Slider 3. This is the one by NextEnd. So what we want to do is install now. And once that's installed, we want to click activate. And activate. Okay, you should see in the left-hand bar over here, Smart Slider, once you've installed and activated that. If you haven't, just make sure that you have gone to plugins and activated that plugin and refresh this page, and you should see Smart Slider in the sidebar. Click on that. Now here's the really cool part. You can actually start creating a new slider like this straight off the bat. I recommend a full width and go through the process to create a slider. However, there's an even more efficient method and faster method, and that is to create a slider using the template library and a set of pre-built templates that are available to you. So if you go into that, you'll see there are a few free templates available to you, and they're indicated by this free banner, and there are also some premium slider templates available to you if you wish to purchase them, which we don't need to do. If you click on any one of them, you'll be able to see that in a preview. So this is an example of one of them that is a premium template. So I'll just close out of this. But if we go into the free section, you should see a good selection of free sliders that are set up and ready to modify, perfect for your WordPress website. So let's start with this one here, the gradient slider. Let's click on that to see a preview. And this is it here. And you can actually customize any one of these features. Obviously, you can customize the text and the buttons and the button links and the images over here, and whether or not these dots appear or these arrows appear, you can customize just about anything. But here's a preview of this free slider. So let's hit import. And that will work to import that slider into your WordPress website. Okay, so that's demo slider free full width. If you scroll down a little now, you'll see that here are the slides that have been imported automatically to your website. If I click save now, just to save the progress we've made, and then check out our website. It will not have been updated yet because we haven't actually activated the slider yet. And I'll show you how to do that. So what you need to do is get this short code, copy everything, including the brackets. And depending on which WordPress theme you have, it'll be slightly different. But if you want to, if you've been following our tutorials to make this website, and if you haven't, just check our channel and you'll be able to see a link to this Make a Website tutorial. But what you need to do is go and copy that link, then go to Customize. And it should be in Theme Settings. Home. And here is our demo slider free full width 2. So we'll go to that and click publish. And now if you refresh our website, it should show up. Of course, this step will be slightly different if you've used a different theme, but essentially what you need to do is get that short code and input that or select that based on the theme that you have. But anyway, here is the beautiful free slider that we've just created or imported for our website. Now, of course, you're going to want to go back in to the slider area and start making some edits. So just to let you know where you are at the moment, if I click on Smart Slider again in the sidebar, you get to this page here, which again allows you to create a new slider or select from the template library. And what you'll be able to do now is hover over and edit the new slider that we have imported. So if you click edit there, you'll get back to this page here. So that's just a little bit of a logistics around getting to this page. So now you can click edit on slide 1. You'll be able to scroll down and edit any of the text here. position of the title and the margins, any of that stuff. Also any colors and fonts. Same for the text there. Same for the button over here. You'll be able to select the fonts, the colors, the size, and also importantly, the name of that link and where it links to. Obviously on your website. When you've made updates, of course you can also change that image over here by just clicking on the image, clicking on this button here, and you'll be able to add a new image from your image library or upload one from your computer. So let's try that. Let's add this. Obviously that image is not the right size. Now I'm counting on you selecting an image that looks good and fits in that area, such as this. And when you make changes, just click on the save button and that will update that particular slide. Okay, so now if we go back to the slider, you'll see that you can update, we've updated that slide there. We can update the second slide and the third slide. And now here's the other cool part over here. And now check this out. This is also really, really cool. If you scroll down a little and go to general, you'll be able to change the size of the actual slider and how it fits on your page. You'll be able to change the animation settings. You'll be able to select whether you want the left and right arrows to show, such as these. And if you don't want them to show, click on this here, but let's leave it as is. And you'll be able to select a whole bunch of other settings for the style of your slider, which is really, really cool. More things such as the little dots that come on the bottom of the image and other stuff like that. So another important setting that you'll want to play with is the size. So right now we've set it to a default width and a height. If you think that's too obstructive and it takes up too much of the page, you can shorten the height, say from 600 to 450. So let's just try 500. And here's the other setting that you'll want to play with possibly, and that's the autoplay setting. If you enable that, the slider will autoplay, so it will rotate through all of your slides, slide 1, 2, 3, and however many slides you've set up. This interval setting is in milliseconds, so 8,000 milliseconds is 8 seconds, so it will automatically rotate every 8 seconds. Let's change that to 5. And here's a setting for stopping autoplay. If someone clicks the mouse, you can stop or enable, in this case, the autoplay to stop. If you deselect that, the autoplay will keep going no matter if somebody clicks on the slide. So that's up to you. It's based on your personal preference. There are a few other ways you can optimize the slider, but these settings here, the general, the size, and the autoplay settings are the main ones that I tend to muck around with when I'm testing what kind of a feel I want for the homepage slider on my WordPress website. So it's all about personal preference. There's no right or wrong there, but if you have any questions, let me know. Let's hit save. And then let's refresh this slider just to see the updates that we have made. So firstly, you'll see that the slider is shorter. We've changed that to 500 pixels tall. We can go even less if we want to. We can also see we've changed the title, we've changed the button link, and we've changed the image. Now, obviously, you can do this for all of your sliders. It's a pre-built slider that looks amazing. If you don't like this one, you can go back into Smart Slider. And at any time, you can go back and create a new slider or select a new one from the template library, and you can preview what one of those looks like. So let's say we don't want that. Let's say we want to check this one out. Okay, that looks pretty cool. We can import that one, and you can edit the text and images and save that. Add the short code to your website. And there you go, you will have added your slider to your WordPress website. If you want to learn how to create an awesome website like this step by step, go to our channel and you'll see a step by step tutorial that's been used by thousands of people around the world to create this website with absolutely no web design costs for free in the space of about 2 hours. Any questions about this, please let me know in the comments below, but give this a big thumbs up if you've learned from this video, and subscribe to our channel for more cool things on how to improve your WordPress website. Catch you in the next video.